Hi, hello, welcome to Unacademy Foundation classes. So today we'll be discussing MCQ questions on fundamental unit of life. So today we'll be talking about different questions of, previous year NTSE, in which we can see certain questions regarding cell and cell organelles. Fine. So before going to the class, note down the timetable. So as you know, every day mathematics video will be premiered. So for 10th standard video will be premiered at 6 p.m. and for 9th standard it will be premiered at 5 p.m. and biology video will be premiered on Saturday and Wednesday. Okay, Saturday and Wednesday, and 10th standard video will be premiered at 5 p.m. and 9th standard will be premiered at 6 p.m. and again physics, chemistry also premiered. So physics will be on Monday and Thursday, chemistry is on Friday and Tuesday, so timing is same, right? Okay, so if you want to connect me, if you have got any sort of doubt regarding biology, you can directly ask me through Telegram app. So for that, first you have to download Telegram app and then type tinyurl.com/unacademyfoundation. So once you are able to, you know, write this URL on the browser, you are able to connect through a group. So once you join to a group, you can ask questions directly in the group or personally as well, right? And one more exciting thing is about Unacademy learning app. So what is so special in this app is, yes, so first of all, we have got different educators, top educators of India, teaching different topics, different subjects. So it can be UPSC, SSC and CAT, MAT, NEET, ITJE, Foundation. So first download an Academy learning app to explore. So once you download an Academy learning app, open it and then click on yes, plus option. So when you click on plus option, you are able to see this screen. So you are able to see different goals. So what is your goal? So since you are the students of class 8, 9th, 10th standard, you can go for Foundation and NTSC. So even though the name is Foundation and NTSC, it's not that we only teach for NTSE or, you know, preparation of ITJE or NEET. We also help you to prepare different competitive exams like NSCJS as well, National Science Olympiad, NSTSE. And along with this, we'll be helping you to prepare for NEET exam right from your NEET as well as ITJE, right from your 9th and 10th standard. Okay, yes. So when you click on Foundation and NTSE, you're able to see this screen. So click on get subscription. So when you click on get subscription, you are able to see different month subscription. So you can go for any one of this. Okay. So, but 12 month and 24 month is really affordable. So if you compare to other coaching centers or other such platform, the cost is very less. Okay. Because here you just have to pay less than 50 rupees per day. Okay. And don't forget to use the code FoundationLive. Even if you want to take the subscription of maybe NEET or JEE, because some of our students, they are really smart enough. They have already covered all the concepts of class 9th and 10th. So such students can directly take the subscription of NEET and JEE, but use our code FoundationLive. And one more important thing, exciting thing, you can also listen to the free classes. Yes. You can get access to free classes in all the category, in all the goals by clicking on special class. So you're basically able to experience plus for free. Okay. Yes. So starting the class. So before discussing different concepts, different questions of fundamental unit of life, what you have to do is please like the video, subscribe to our channel. Fine. Yes. So the very first question is, turgidity of the cell is maintained by. So what is this turgidity of the cell? So basically, especially plant cells, they swell when they intake water. When they uptake water, plant cell, they swell. Okay. So this is called as turgidity, turgor or turgidity. Okay, turgidity of the cell is nothing but swelling of the cell because of uptaking water. That's it. But how exactly turgidity of the cell is maintained? So turgidity of the cell is maintained by, yes, you're right, vacuole. So what is this vacuole? So do human cells also have got vacuoles? Or is it that only plant cells have got vacuole? Both animals and plant cells, they have got vacuole. But in the case of animal cell, the size of the vacuole is very small. Okay. And it is important to store the waste material. So this is like a sac-like structure. So in the case of plants, the vacuoles are very large. And it is a few in number, but still, the size of this vacuole is very large. So basically, they will be able to store water and nutrients in the case of plants. So basically, turgidity of the cell is maintained by vacuole, because vacuole will be able to store water and other nutrients. Okay, so sometimes we are also able to see pigments, okay, like anthocyanin inside the vacuole. So answer is vacuole here. You know, other structure, lysosome, Golgi apparatus, plastid is present only in the case of plants. Lysosome, suicide bag, is present only in the case of animal cell. Golgi apparatus is common for both animal and plant cell. So this has been appeared in NTSE 2017 and 18, Rajasthan. Okay, so we have understood lot of things here. So going to the next question, the common component of membrane of organelles like mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum and nucleus is. So which is the common component of membrane? Okay, so basically the question is, the common component of the membrane of organelles like these are. So what is the common in the membrane that we are able to see in these organelles? Options: glycolipid, glycoprotein, nucleoprotein, lipoprotein. So this question is quite tricky, complicated, right? Yes, of course. Many of you were requesting, ma'am, Bihar's NTSE question is difficult. So please help us, right? So this is why I have put up more questions of Bihar NTSE. Okay, yes. So what is the answer? What should be the answer? Glycolipid. What is glycolipid? First of all, these things can be seen in the membrane. We have seen in the fluid mosaic model of plasma membrane, we have seen different components like glycoprotein, lipoprotein, glycolipid. Yes. So glycolipid is combination of carbohydrate and lipid. So basically, carbohydrate moiety, when it will be binding to the bilipid layer, we call them as a glycolipid. And coming to glycoprotein, what is glycoprotein? Carbohydrate moiety which is bound to the protein. It can be integral or, you know, peripheral proteins which is present in the membrane, right? So coming to the next option, lipoprotein. So what is lipoprotein? Lipoprotein is combination of lipid and proteins. So this is common in most of the membrane of different organelles. Okay, so lipoprotein, so phospholipid layer and peripheral or integral protein we are able to see in all different types of membranes, right? So answer is lipoprotein. Of course, nucleoprotein we are not able to see in the membranes, right? So nucleoprotein is combination of proteins and nucleic acid. Okay, so what can be the example for nucleoprotein? Histones and DNA. Nucleosome, yes. So I hope you have understood why exactly lipoprotein is the right answer. You can always ask me questions in the comment box, but not in the live chat, because later, after the premiering, I won't be able to answer in the live chat. So better ask questions only in the comments, so that even after premiering, I'll be able to answer. But of course, please connect through Telegram app if you have got doubt, because that would be better. I will be able to, you know, send you images, like if you want to, understand certain concepts better, along with the images, along with the description, I can explain you. Yes. So let's go for the next question. So yes, plant cell become turgid due to. Just now we have talked about what is turgid cell, how exactly turgidity occurs. Yes, because of vacuole, it is able to maintain the turgidity. So it is nothing but uptaking of water, right? Plant cell become turgid due to which of these processes? Plasmolysis, exosmosis, endosmosis, electrolysis. Electrolysis, of course, not, because electrolysis, you can see this term in chemistry and physics more, right? But confusion is between exosmosis and endosmosis. Most of you may have confusion, okay? So what is this exosmosis? Exosmosis. So we know what is the meaning of ex. Ex is no more. So excretion is removal of waste material, right? Removal is nothing but ex. So removal of or releasing of water molecules or solvent can be called as exosmosis, release of solvent. Or water molecules can be called as exosmosis. So what will happen if exosmosis happens in the case of plant cells? Cell will be losing all of its water molecules, all of its solvent molecules. So cell will become shrinked, right? So when the cell shrinks, we call them as a plasmolyzed cells. They are not turgid cells. Okay, so answer is not C. What is endosmosis? Endo is inside. Osmosis means movement of solvent water molecules from the region of its higher concentration to the region of its lower concentration. So basically movement of water molecules from outside to the inside of the cell is called as endosmosis. So when water molecules moves inside to the cell, what happens? The cell will swell, right? Cell will become turgid. So endosmosis is the right answer. What is plasmolysis? So I have told you, plasmolyzed cell, when cell is kept in hypertonic solution, when the cell is kept in hypertonic solution, so surrounding solution is hypertonic, host solute concentration is more, okay? So solvent which is present in the cell will come out into the hypertonic solution. So what happens when all the solvent molecules inside the cells comes out of the cell? The cell will shrivel, the cell will shrink, which will be able to show the condition of plasmolysis. So this is nothing but plasmolysis, right? So but here answer is endosmosis. So going for the next question, actually this question was very easy. Yes, which one of the following organelle does not possess double layered covering? So basically question is which of the organelles are not having double membrane? Okay, so what is the answer? Options are chloroplast, nucleus, mitochondria and vacuole. So chloroplast, mitochondria, nucleus, they all have got double membrane. So we have talked about all these organelles in detail in the beginning chapter of fundamental unit of life, right? Whereas vacuole, they do not have double membrane, they just have one membrane. So membrane of vacuole is called as stenoplast. So this particular word, tonoplast, and this particular question regarding vacuole is very, very frequently, like they have been given not only in NTSE as well as in NSCGS. So please remember, membrane of vacuole is tonoplast. And one more question regarding tonoplast has been appeared, that which of the organelle is not true plastid? So options can be chromoplast, chloroplast, leucoplast and tonoplast. So tonoplast, it is not a plastid. Just by seeing this word plast, don't think that it is a plastid. It is the outer membrane of vacuole, a empty space or a sac which is able to maintain solvent or water molecules in the case of plants, and in the case of animals they are also able to store waste materials as well, right? Yes, so we have discussed some 2-3 questions in this particular question now. Yes. So let's go for the next question. Yes, again Bihar, because many of you you have problem with the Bihar NTSE question paper. So nucleosome present in the eukaryotic cell is a part of. Actually, the it's not a great problem in the case of Bihar NTSE question papers. Concepts are like properly, they will be explaining in the question, but options will be quite tricky. So only the students who have, whoever have understood the concept very well, they will be able to answer the question better. Okay. So the question, nucleosome is present in the eukaryotic cell in which part? So part of the nucleus, part of the chromosome, part of the nucleolus, part of the ribosome. So this also have taught you nucleosomal model of DNA. So DNA is basically wound with the help of histone proteins, right? So octamer of histones will be wound along with the DNA to form nucleosome. But these nucleosome is actually present in where? In chromosome. So it is a part of what? Chromosome. Why exactly DNA need to be wound along with the histone proteins? In order to store the long genetic material, that is DNA, whose length is in meters. So this cell is really microscopic, and inside the nucleus you are able to see chromosome, and in that chromosome we are able to see meters of long DNA wound along with the histone proteins to store genetic material inside the chromosome. Okay, so actually nucleosome is a part of chromosome, and chromosome is present in the nucleus, right? So why not part of nucleus, ma'am? Anybody might have question. So the question is about, you know, they want a specific answer. Yes, I agree, chromosome will be present in nucleus, but nucleosome is present in chromosome, right? So most right answer would be C. Okay, yes, of course, part of nucleolus cannot be the answer. Okay, and part of ribosome again. No, ribosome is not related here. So going for the next question. Yes, cell organelle storing substances like oil, starch and proteins is. So options are vacuole, lysosome, plastid, Golgi body. Organelle storing substances like starch, oil and proteins. Plastids. So again, I have taught you different types of plastids in our previous class. Previous class in the sense, maybe before some 2 months, we had covered fundamental unit of life, that is about cell and cell organelles. So I have taught you different types of plastids, right? So plastids can be divided into chromoplasts or chromoplast and leucoplast. Chromoplast example can be chloroplast. Right? Why chromo? Colored plastid. They are able to store pigments. So chlorophyll is a pigment. Correct? So coming to leucoplast. Leucoplast, they are non-colored plastid. Again, they are divided into amyloplast, elaioplast. Amyloplast, they are able to store carbohydrate, sugar material. Starch is stored in amyloplast. Proteinoplast, proteins are stored. Elaioplast, fat globules, fat molecules are stored. So, cell organelle storing the substances like protein, starch and oil is called as, is nothing but plastid. So, going for the next question. Selective permeability means it allows entry of certain substance only. It allows exit of certain substances only. It allows passage of all solutes and solvents. Okay. D says it allows entry and exit of certain substances and prevents remaining substances. So this is actually quite easy because I have properly taught you about osmosis, endosmosis, exosmosis, plasmolysis, during which we also have talked about semi-permeable. So selectively permeable, just by understanding the word selective, you are able to answer this question. So it basically allows entry and exit of certain substances and it will be preventing the other remaining substances. So again, recent question paper of Telangana. Going for the next question, which is not correct. So please let me know if you have got doubt. I keep repeating this. Yes, which is not correct here. Embryology is Aristotle. So these are the scientist name and these are the field of study that they have done. Okay. Yes. So paleontology, Leonardo da Vinci, taxonomy, Carolus Linnaeus. You actually here, no need of, knowing about all of these options. If you know all the scientists' name, not all, most of the scientists' name, whatever we have discussed in our previous classes and their study and research. If you know those, you are able to answer this question directly. Cytology, Robert Brown. So now most of you may get confusion because you do not know about paleontology, taxonomy, embryology in much in depth. You know about cytology very well. Father of cytology. Cytology is nothing but study of cell, right? So answer is actually Robert Hooke here, not Robert Brown. Robert Brown discovered nucleus, right? Robert Hooke discovered cell and cell wall, right? So he is called as father of cytology and he has done research and he has studied under cell cytology, right? So going for the next question. Yes. The subunits of ribosomes in cells of nephron of mouse. So examiner want to make the question quite complicated. He want to make you panic. This is very simple question actually. The basically question is subunits of ribosome of eukaryotic cell. Okay? Because you know that mouse is eukaryote. Nephron is a cell. That's it. So ribosomes have got different subunits. So eukaryotic cell have got ATS ribosome, which has got 60 and 40S. This is Swedberg units. It's not that 60 plus 40 is equal to 100S, ma'am. Why ATS? No, it's not in that way. The ribosome subunits have given these numbers. It's Swedberg units. Okay. So here we know eukaryotic cells. They have got ATS ribosome, which is made up of 60S and 40S subunits. Whereas prokaryotic cells, they have got 70S ribosome, which is made up of 50S and 30S subunits. Okay. Remember, it is not just you're adding the number and you're getting 100 or 80 or 70. Okay. So let's go for the next question. Various colors of flowers and fruits in plants are due to presence of, again Bihar, yes, expected. Various colors of flowers and fruits. So we are able to see different colors. If you consider flowers or fruits, the coat color, right? So basically why we are able to see these different colors? What is the organelle which is responsible for this? So options are chromoplast, leucoplast, colored pigments in cytoplasm, protoplast. Again, even if you do not know the answer, if you know the meaning of certain word, you are able to answer this question. Yes, what is the answer? Just now I have told you, before some slides, some questions I have told you, chromoplast, which is nothing but colored plastid, which is able to store pigments. Example, I have told you, I have given you chloroplast. So certain chromoplast, they are able to store pigments like carotenoids, xanthophylls, right? Also other pigments. So what is the answer here? Chromoplast. So chromo is, what is the meaning of chromo? Is color. Plastid, you know what is plastid, right? So here answer is chromoplast. So going for the next question. In human blood group AB, these answer, these options, antibodies are present, antibodies are absent, antibodies A is present, antibody B is present. Again, Bihar expected, right? Yes, actually, I have not covered this concept under fundamental unit of life, but let me tell you, when we tell that, yes, I have got, I'm AB blood group. So somebody is B positive. So, I may be A positive, right? So what does this blood group says about? So AB blood group means they have got antigens A and antigens B. So we have also studied this concept under codominance in the special classes of Sundays. I hope you remember under codominance and also multiple allelism. Remember, blood grouping is not, it cannot come under polygenic inheritance. It belongs to multiple allelism. Okay. So many alleles are involved in giving rise to different types of blood groups, but only one gene is involved. Okay. Yes. So here, what is the answer? I have just now have told you, right? When somebody told you, when somebody tells you that they have got AB blood group, it means that they have got antigens A and B, and there is no antibodies for A and B. Okay. So in the case of blood group, both antibodies for same allele cannot be present if there is presence of, you know, same type of antigen. So if the blood group is A, so that individual will have antigen A and antibody B. Okay. So whenever this blood group A individual, if he is able to get blood from blood group B individual, because of the presence of antibody B in individual, okay, let me, yes, this is a person who has got blood group A. Let's not talk about positive and negative here. He will be having antigen A and antibody B. So if he accidentally gets blood from blood group B individual, blood group B individual will be having antigen B, antibody A. What will happen? There will be death of the individual, whoever getting the blood from the blood group B. Why? He is able to produce antibody B. So antibody B and antigen B, they are able to show agglutination. Okay. So hence, blood group A individual cannot get blood from blood group B because there will be antigen antibody reaction can happen when he is able to get blood from blood group B individual. Okay. Yes. So this is why there won't be transfusion of blood between A and B individual. Yes. So what is the answer here? Antibodies are absent. Both the antibodies A and B is absent because you're able to see both the antigen A and B is present in the case of individual who has got blood group AB, right? So I hope you have understood, but still if you have got doubt, please let me know. Yes, so this is all for today. Thank you so much for watching and take the subscription as soon as possible. You can take the subscription of NEET as well, JEE as well, if you feel that you want even more advanced topics. But don't forget to use our code FOUNDATIONLIVE. Okay, so this is the love for you which we are giving. Okay, yes. So also please subscribe to our channel and keep sharing the video. Most importantly, like the video. So share the video by giving the hashtag Live School Daily. Okay, and yes, click on the bell icon so that you won't be missing any of the classes. So thank you so much. So let's meet in the coming classes. Bye bye.